So good day students, you're welcome to the class. Today we're going to talk about measurement of heat energy. So by the end of the lesson, you expected to know what is latent heat of fission and latent heat of vaporization. What is latent heat? Heating a substance does not always increase the temperature. If heat is supplied to a block of ice at 0 degrees Celsius, it melts and becomes water at the temperature of 0 degrees Celsius. A thermometer dipped in the melting ice does not show increase in temperature despite the fact that heat energy is being applied to it. The heat supplied to the ice during the process is called latent heat. So latent heat is used to break the bonds between molecules and to push them apart. It does not increase the kinetic energy of the molecules, therefore the temperature remains constant. So we'll talk about specific latent heat of fission. It is the energy needed to change 1 kilogram of a solid to liquid at a constant temperature. Heat absorbed is equal to mass times latent heat. You can see the representation below, where we have the L subscript F to be equal to specific latent heat of fission, and the unit is in joule per kilogram or in joule per gram. So the specific latent heat of ice is given as 336,000 joule per kilogram. So this means that 336,000 joule per kilogram is needed to melt completely 1 kilogram of ice. So when we talk about latent heat of fission, it is the heat energy needed to change any given mass of a solid to a liquid at a constant temperature. So we have an example here. Question 1 says, given that the latent heat of fission of ice is 336,000 joule per kilogram, the specific heat energy of ice and water is 2,100 joule per kilogram per Kelvin and 4,200 joule per kilogram per Kelvin respectively. Calculate the heat needed to change 2 kg of ice at 0 degrees Celsius to water at 30 degrees Celsius. So, and 2 says we should change, also calculate the heat needed to change 1.2 kg of ice at minus 20 degrees Celsius to water at 0 degrees Celsius. Solution, we have to find the heat needed to change 2 kg of ice at 0 degrees Celsius to water at 30 degrees Celsius. First of all, we have to find the heat that took place to change it from what? Ice, from ice to water. That is the latent heat of fission. Then plus the heat change, that is from 0 degrees Celsius to what? 30 degrees Celsius. So these are the 2 to add together to give us the answer. So we have to substitute. The formula is heat is equal to mass times latent heat of fission plus mass of what? The ice given, then times the specific heat capacity of water, then times change in temperature. So we simplify, we have our answer to be 924,000 joules. Then in 2, they say we should find the heat needed to change 1.2 kg of ice at minus 20 degrees Celsius to water at 0 degrees Celsius. So the heat here, we have to find the heat change in temperature from the heat needed to change the temperature from what? Minus 20 degrees Celsius to 0 degrees Celsius. Then plus the heat needed to change the ice to water too. That is the latent heat. So the 2 addition, using this particular given formula up there that explains this illustration, that is mass times specific heat capacity of ice times change in temperature plus mass times latent specific latent heat of fission. Then we substitute the values and we have the answer to be 453,600 joules. Then the number 2 question says, a copper of mass 0.5 kg contains 1.5 kg of water at 30 degrees Celsius. If the cup and its contents are placed in the deep freezer at minus 10 degrees Celsius, we should find the total heat loss by the cup and water to reach the same temperature as the deep freezer. We are given the specific heat capacity of copper and water as 400 joule per kilogram per Kelvin and 4,200 joule per kilogram per Kelvin, and also the specific latent heat of fission of ice to be given us is also given as 136,000 joule per kilogram. So for us to calculate the total heat loss here, which is what we are asked to find, we have to first of all find the heat loss by the copper and then add it towards the heat loss by the, that is the heat loss by the copper, then add it to the heat loss by the water. So these are the two things we have to find and sum it together, then it gives us the total heat loss. So the heat loss by the copper here is just the mass times specific heat capacity of copper, then times change in temperature. This gives us the heat loss by the copper, and that is 8,000 joules. Then we talk about the heat loss by the water. We have to talk about that of the water, then that of the latent heat, and that of the ice. So the three of them together make up what the heat loss by the water. So that of the water will be giving us, the formula will be mass times specific heat capacity, mass of water times specific heat capacity of water times change in temperature, then plus the mass times latent heat of, that is specific latent heat of fission, then plus mass of ice times specific heat capacity of ice times change in temperature. So we take these informations that we are given, then we substitute here, and we found the heat loss by the water, which is 724,500 joules. So for us to find the total heat loss, the total heat loss here is equals to, that is heat loss by the copper plus heat loss by the water. So when we sum the two together, it will be giving us 732,500 joules. So we move to determination of specific latent heat of fission of ice. Heat gained by ice is giving us mass times latent heat of fission, then plus mass times specific heat capacity times change in temperature. Also, heat loss by water is giving us mass times specific heat capacity, that is mass of water times specific heat capacity of water times change in temperature. Then heat loss by calorimeter is giving us mass of calorimeter times specific heat capacity of calorimeter times change in temperature. Then heat loss by water and calorimeter, which is equals to heat gain by the ice, is giving us then mass times specific heat, that is mass of water times specific heat capacity of water times change in temperature, then plus mass of calorimeter times specific heat capacity of calorimeter times change in temperature, then equals to mass times what, latent specific latent heat of fission, then plus mass times specific heat capacity times change in what, temperature. So the melting point of a substance is the constant temperature at which it changes from solid to liquid. We have factors affecting melting point of a substance. One is impurities. It alters the melting point of a substance. Two is pressure. Pressure changes the melting point and freezing point of a substance. So when we talk about latent heat of vaporization, if energy is constantly supplied to water, it boils when the temperature is 100 degrees Celsius. The temperature of the water remains constant at 100 degrees Celsius as water changes from water to steam. If enough energy is supplied to the water, it changes to steam in a process known as vaporization. Vaporization of water occurs at a constant temperature at 100 degrees Celsius. The heat energy supplied to the steam is not registered by the thermometer, and it is called latent heat of vaporization. So, specific latent heat of vaporization is the heat energy required to convert 1 kg of liquid to vapor at constant temperature. The specific heat of vaporization is 2,260,000 joule per kilogram. That is the energy needed to convert completely 1 kg of water at boiling point to steam at the same temperature. So the quantity of energy absorbed or radiated by a substance to change its state is given by heat energy equals to mass times specific latent heat of vaporization. That is, heat energy is equals to mass times what, specific latent heat of vaporization. So we have example here. The question says we should calculate the heat absorbed for 1 kg of ice at 0 degrees Celsius to be converted to steam at 100 degrees Celsius. We have the specific heat capacity of water to be given, the latent fission of ice to be given, and the specific latent heat of vaporization 2 is given. For us to calculate the heat absorbed by 1 kg of ice at 0 degrees Celsius, to be converted to steam at 100 degrees Celsius. So to solve this, we have to know that heat is equal to that means heat here is equal to the latent heat of fusion plus heat change from 0 degrees Celsius to 100 degrees Celsius plus the latent heat of vaporization, that is specific latent heat of vaporization. So these are the three things we are going to sum together. Then we have to take the informations given, that is the specific heat capacity of water, latent fusion of ice, and so on, then substitute into this particular equation. Then we simplify and we have the heat here to be equals to 3,016,000 joule as the answer. So the question number 4 says, a solid copper of mass 500 gram at a temperature of 0 degrees Celsius is dropped into a vessel containing 300 gram of water at 40 degrees Celsius. If the mass of the water that boils away is 20 gram, calculate the initial temperature of the copper solid. They say neglect heat capacity of the vessel. We are given the specific heat capacity of water, specific heat capacity of copper, and the latent specific latent heat of vaporization. These we are given also, are also known as constant too. So to find the temperature of the copper solid mass, we have to solve for heat loss by the copper solid, then equate the answer we have there to heat gain by the water. So solving for the heat loss by the copper solid, the formula is mass times specific heat capacity of copper, then times change in temperature, and we solve for it, you have the final value, which is 200, then open bracket theta minus 100, then close the bracket. Don't forget that the theta there is the initial temperature of the copper solid, which was not given, so it's vacant. Then we'll move over to solving for the heat gain by the water. The formula is right here, mass times specific heat capacity, then times change in temperature, plus mass times specific heat, specific latent heat of vaporization. Then we substitute our information into this equation and we have the answer to be 120,800 joules. Then for us to find the theta, that is the initial temperature of the copper solid, we have to equate these two answers. Then when we equate them, we have the final answer to be theta equals to 740 degrees Celsius. So in summary, specific latent heat of fusion is the energy needed to change 1 kilogram of a solid to liquid at a constant temperature. So the formula is Q is equals to M times latent heat of fusion. So latent heat of fusion is the heat energy needed to change any given mass of a solid to liquid at a constant temperature. When we talk about specific latent heat of vaporization, it is the heat energy required to convert 1 kg of liquid to vapor at constant temperature. The specific heat of vaporization is 2,260,000 joules. So for the assignment, please attend to the question, and if you find it difficult trying to assimilate any of the questions or the lessons we had earlier, please try to leave your comment at the comment section below. God bless you.